What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to some more Littleroot laddering. If you're watching this when this goes live up on Friday the 24th, I'm currently in Knoxville. I'm most likely at the convention center when this goes live, so come find me. That'd be great. So, let's talk about what we're doing today. This past weekend was Ocic. It was won by none other than Gavin Micheals, whose team we actually are playing today. So let's talk about this team just a little bit. AV Iron Hands is probably the most common set. If I was a betting man, I'm going to look it up on Peekalytics just to confirm. Yep, AV is by far the most common set here at 62%. Citrus is at 22%. I really like hands in this format. It's absurdly powerful. Being able to pivot in and out around, you know, being able to be like trapped thanks to Gothitelle and stuff like that with Volt Switch is really awesome. Having Terra Grass means that you're immune to all these spores running around on Amoongus and Brute Bonnet, as well as, Rage Powders, which is why sometimes you also see Safety Goggles on hands. Just being able to ignore the redirection, I think, is really big for this. You just are able to dish out a ton of damage in close combat and wild charge, as well as provide really good support to your team with Fake Out. So from there, we have Amoongus as well to, you know, be able to do Amoongus things. Citrus Berry, Regenerator, Spore, Pollen Puff, you know, just typical Amoongus things, right? Nothing overly surprising there. From there, we have our rain duo of Pelipper and Palafin. Pelipper sets rain, Palafin does a ton of damage. Thanks to rain, it does even more damage. It's just a really good duo. Palafin having access to haze here is actually really awesome. It gives us a really solid answer into Dondozo if we do run into it. And, like, you know, Pelipper is able to do its thing with, like, Tailwind, hit 100% accurate Hurricanes, hit really powerful Hydro Pumps in the rain as well. Pelipper really misses Scald, and, like, honestly, I've flip-flopped back and forth on either I love that Scald is gone, or I miss it deeply, and it depends on the Pokemon. And Pelipper is one that I'm just like, man, I really wish we had Scald instead of Hydro Pump. But, it is what it is. We also have Baxcalibur and Dragonite to round this team out. Being able to just do a ton of damage here with Baxcalibur, I think, is really sick. Dragon Fang with only Glaive Rush is interesting, but you're able to do just so much damage with it that I don't think it really matters. You can just Glaive Rush into Protect and or Ice Shard the next turn, be able to prevent your opponent from really getting to abuse that double damage on you. Just Ice Shard and Icicle Crash are just huge, huge damage sources from Baxcalibur. And of course, Dragonite here. Pokemon, I have historically said, I don't think this thing's very good. And then I went and got bodied by it last week in Bowerdad's tournament. And here I am playing it again this week. So let's see if I like this Dragonite set more than the last one we played. I think Multiscale is pretty good. I like Interfocus quite a bit as well. Lumberry is, I actually think, really good on Dragonite. Being able to just ignore like a burn or a sleep or something from Dragonite is really important, especially in these like closed team sheet formats that we're playing here today. So I'm excited to see how well Dragonite actually performs, especially having access to Stab, Flying, Terra Blast. It's going to be able to just do a ton of damage, as well as, you know, E-Speed and Ice Spinner to take away terrain if need be. So that's the team. Huge shout outs to Gavin Micheals for putting this rental up for us. And let's jump into the ladder and see what we can do today. Ooh, sand duo of Houndstone, T-Tar. Now, something you see a lot of, and I'm actually really excited for it. Being able to pair T-Tar with Great Tusk, I think, is also really interesting as well. And, of course, you know, Talonflame is just, like, a really good staple partner for these T-Tar teams as well. Just the T-Tar, Great Tusk, Talonflame teams is something that has been running around for a while. And, going into Knoxville, I had a lot of thought of, like, playing something similar to it because it's just super hyper offensive, right? So, I think Pelipper is, like, a must-bring here because I want to be able to control the weather as I choose. I also think that Iron Hands is a must-bring in, like, 100% of the games as well. I'm interested in Palafin and probably Baxcalibur as well It's just a matter of who do I want where? And I think the correct answer is like Palafin plus Iron Hands with Pelipper and Vaxcalibur in the back. I could see bringing Vaxcalibur up front just to be able to prevent like a Tailwind from going up, but you know, we're gonna be slower than Talonflame anyway, so even if we Ice Shard and double into it, they're gonna be able to outspeed and get their Tailwind up that way with Gale Wings active. So let's see what we got going on here. So we are Booster Energy Bundle here from our opponent. I'm gonna get that speed boost. I could Jet Punch the Talonflame here. I kind of like just Protect plus Wild Charge into the bundle. Take it out before it gets to do anything. Okay, they're just gonna also protect. That's pretty okay for us, all things considered. I thought going for Fake Out here into the Talonflame is probably just not worth it because they could be Covert Cloak. And see, that's really annoying. That's really, really annoying. But honestly, I don't think it's that big of a deal. I think now we can go into Pelipper here. And I think I want to Volt Switch off of the bundle, get in our Palafin hero form. It'll be in next to Pelipper that way, under Rain. So yeah, I'm pretty okay with this play. Obviously the burn sucks. Had we known they had access to Will-O-Wisp, if we were playing this open team sheet, you know, a switch there into Vaxcalibur could have been really useful. It's gonna put us down to our Sash, and that's completely fine. And they're just gonna Will-O-Wisp there as well, which is just going to get the burn off. Volt Switch is going to do massive damage into the bundle. Holy cow, hold on. Now we can go into Palafin here. Pelipper is going to go down to its burn, which is going to again give me a free switch into this is going to let me bring back in Iron Hands, go for Fake Out into the Talonflame plus Jet Punch, and that should KO before they ever get to attack this turn with Gale Wings active. Like, even if they're Covert Cloak, getting the flinch doesn't matter. The important part is breaking Gale Wings here, so this is going to most likely be, yep, just Protect from the bundle. And I bet Jet Punch is actually enough to KO the bundle next turn, especially if I Terra. Rain boosted, Terra boosted, Mystic Water boosted, Jet Punch does a ton of damage to basically everything that exists. And like, another Volt Switch also just KOs the bundle. So I can just Protect and Volt Switch, get to bring in wasn't ready for the dog to come out. That's kind of interesting. Because this could be bundle into T-Tar. I think I'm still going to Volt Switch there. And I think I am going to Terra Water and go for the Jet Punch into the Houndstone this turn. Okay, it looks like they're staying in. Interested in see what they do here. They could Protect the Houndstone, and then they get a free switch into T-Tar this way. Okay, no protect coming out. That's probably a KO. Yep, by a mile. I'm assuming, yep, freeze dry. But not into the Mon that really needed to get freeze dry. Okay, just a double. Double KO there is really good for us. And now I get a free switch in to Baxcalibur as well to deal with whatever the last Pokemon is. I have Ice Shard, I have Icicle Crash, I have Glaive Rush here. I'm just going to do a 1,000,000,000% to everything that's going on, so. Feeling pretty okay here. Yep, Tyranitar is their last, and I just do not think it matters. So we will Glaive Rush. And I'm going to Wave Crash just to guarantee the KO. Yep, they are going to Terra. Probably Flying. Yep. And, you know, it's just really just not going to matter. This isn't Rain Boosted anymore, but it's still Mystic Water Boosted, and it's a Wave Crash. Are they Sash, or do they naturally live on one? Nope. Naturally lived on one. And we get the crit for good measure, so that always feels good. So, Palafin's really good. And we just got to punish our opponent for it, basically, the entire time. We just got to just make them sad. Ooh, hard Trick Room. Hard Trick Room here. Pelipper seems really good as a way of dealing with their Torkoal. Like, being able to control the weather the way we want seems really impactful. As well as Baxcalibur. I think Baxcalibur being able to get that attack boost off of Eruption seems really impactful. I think this is where D-Knight really is going to shine. I think Dragonite seems really good. As does... Do I want Palafin? I think this is double Dragon with the Rain Duo in the back. It might seem weird to bring Palafin in the back, but I think it's just going to be needed as a way... Like, this may be a game where, unfortunately, we don't get to transform Palafin. I don't know. I think they have a guaranteed Trick Room here with Ndidi plus Oranguru. I don't really see a way I can get around that. Okay, so I get Ice Spinner plus Glaive Rush. That will be a guaranteed KO into the Ndidi, most likely. I am going to target down the Oranguru, though, just in the off chance that they don't protect. I mean, they don't follow me. Okay, so this should be a very KO'd Ndidi. I would classify that as very KO'd. Alright, now Terrain's gone. Trick Room is going to go up. This gives him a free swap into presumably Torkoal. Which then means I can swap out into Pelipper. Take back control of the weather. And then I can, like... Oh, it's going to be King Gambit. Okay. I'm picking up what you're putting down here. But with Terrain being gone... I can E-Speed... I kind of want to play around Sucker Punch this turn by just protecting. I think I want to go ahead and Terra Blast, and I want to go into... No, I think this needs to be E-Speed, and just try to... I think I need to try to KO the Oranguru this turn. Okay. Ah, oh, they're Citrus. Dang, I was really hoping they were Mental Herb. So I'm losing something, yep. Oh, hopefully not both. Hopefully the Instruct is not enough to KO my, my Dragonite here as well. Oh. Not even close. So now I can bring in Palafin. This will let me set up Hero Mode. Honestly, there's a non-zero chance that a Oranguru protects this turn. I am going to protect and swap into Pelipper. Get Hero Mode activated. Because they had to anticipate, like, E-Speed and Jet Punch this turn to KO the Oranguru. Yep, perfect. Hopefully this is, like, Sucker Punch? Okay, it's just Iron Head into Dragonite, but that's fine. So now I can... I can E-Speed into our Oranguru, pick up the KO there. And... I think just Hydro Pump into the King Gambit. I was gonna say, Hydro Pump gets punished by them swapping into Torkoal this turn. I think this is just fine. Dragonite still holds on, which is also very good for us. And we connect the Hydro Pump as well, and we know they're Life Orbs, so yeah, Hydro Pump's enough to KO. Does it bother anyone else that Pelipper has fingers? Because it really bothers me. Last turn of Trick Room. This is going to be Protect and... They haven't Terra'd yet. I think this is E-Speed. And swap into Palafin. I think Palafin can take a hit here. Okay. Yeah, opponent is going to just call it there. Which I do agree with. We were pretty guaranteed to pick up a game like the KO there. So, not really worried about how that game played out. Rain Mirror. They also have Iron Hands and Amoongus. We haven't brought Amoongus yet. Do I think Amoongus is good here? It's good into, like, Palafin. Being able to put that thing to sleep seems really appealing. And honestly, Hand seems pretty good, too. I think I want, like, Palafin plus Hands, Amoongus, and... One of the dragons. I'm leaning towards Baxcalibur. Yeah, I think this is gonna be D-Knight. I think I wanna play with some D-Knight today. Not quite max attack. Pretty dang close though. Yep, I think this is it. I think letting them potentially have Tailwind is fine. because I think I'm just going to try to play through it as much as possible. And I don't want to bring Rain for them to then have, like, boosted Rain with Palafin and Bundle. I think Bundle's a must-bring on their side, as it's their lead. Perfect. So Bundle could protect. I think Palafin could also swap out here. Looking at their team, Hands could be their swap in, and if that's the case, I think I just want to close combat into the Palafin slot. And then I think I'm going to swap here into... probably Amoongus? I think Hands is really important to be able to deal with the Bundle. And I think they just protect here. Yeah, give me that Hands HP. Bundle does protect, which tells me they're probably not Covert Cloak. Could be Life Orb. And I think here I'm going to swap into Palafin. Man, I really don't want to take extra damage on Palafin, though, on the swap-in. I think Hands has to stay in this turn, unfortunately. I'm going to go for a Wild Charge into Bundle. And I'm going to protect Amoongus this turn. This might be a Terra Amoongus kind of game, you know? Okay. And just go for the fake out into Hands, and they go for the freeze dry there. Okay. All things considered, that turn played out about as much as, like, as well as I anticipated it. So now, I think with that being said, I'm going to swap into Palafin here. I'm going to Terra and go for Spore into the Iron Hands. Because I think, once I'm in hero mode, I think Jet Punch is probably enough to KO it's resisted into the Bundle. But them going for the Freeze Dry into Amoongus last turn makes me think they're going to again this turn. Maybe I need to Spore into the Bundle. Okay. We eat. We also technically eat there. So then this turn I can protect and Spore into the Bundle. Just need to dodge, like, Hydro Pump crit. And they're not Life Orb. Makes me think that they are most likely... Okay, so I could... I'm just going to Wave Crash the Iron Hands and go for a Rage Powder here. If they go for a Freeze Dry, it gets redirected. They're just going to protect. Even better. Gives me a free attack into the Iron Hands this turn. I could always swap out Amoongus into the Iron Hands as well. Iron Hands actually holds on. It's really unfortunate, but that's in range of Jet Punch now. So we'll pick up the KO there, and I think I'm fine to let Palafin go down. I think I need to Spore their Bundle, though. I think Bundle's, like, really, really bad for us if this goes long. So I could be trading Palafin for Hands this turn, which if so, I'm fine with that trade. Because then I get to bring in my Hands against their Palafin. Okay, they're just going to withdraw. Are they going back into theirs? They are! interesting. I mean, I get free chip on theirs. They do go for the hydro, but we live. Oh, we eat for days. Now they're going to take a little nap. I'm going to protect and spore. Actually, I think this is a perfect turn to swap into Dragonite, maybe? I think Hands is really good here. I think I eat a Wave Crash. I think their team looks really tired, guys. I think their whole team just needs to take some naps. What do you all think? Gotta remember, Hands has one turn of sleep on it already. Bundle now has its one turn of sleep. We don't eat that. Nope. Okay. I was really hoping not to see close combat, but that's fine. They have not Terra'd yet. That is important to remember. Alright. Free swap into Dragonite. They could swap out Palafin this turn. I think this is super, super safe to try to pick up the bundle this turn, because I think they're going to swap out Palafin. So I think this is just pivot out Hands with Volt Switch and E-Speed into the bundle to pick up the KO. I think they're going to try to stay in and go for Freeze Dry into the Dragonite, pick up the KO on it. But I am multi-scale, so I'm going to get the live the hit. So the play around that, they should stay in and go for Jet Punch, but they don't. Presumably, this is going to be Iron Hands coming back in, who's still asleep. Also, very, very close to KO range. So we break the Sash. Volt Switch shouldn't be enough to KO here. But that puts it well within E-Speed plus, like, E-Speed range this turn. So Palafin's going to come out. This is bad if they... I think to play around Iron Hands waking up, I need to Jet Punch and E-Speed into the bundle. But this is really bad if they go for Protect. Bundle is definitely the bigger threat between these two. And I'm hoping that they don't wake up and get the Protect. Okay, Iron Hands also just stays asleep. That's completely fine. E-Speed picks up the bundle, so I don't have to worry about it. And then Jet Punch should be enough to pick up the Hands. I was going to say, if not, I'm going to be very upset with Palafin. But it's fine. So we know they have CC. They should also have Jet Punch. Wave Crash Protect, most likely. And they have Pelipper as their last. Things just got really interesting. Because they have two things that are very, very weak to Iron Hands. I'm going to break the Sash here on Pelipper. Now I'm going to get some chip in on this Palafin. Multiscale still intact. I'm just going to try to break the Sash here on Pelipper. They still have their Terra. So they could be Terra Water or Terra Fighting on the Palafin. This could be Pelipper. In all actuality, it's not. But it could have been. Could have been like Terra Flying Palafin. You know what, Dragonite? That's pretty okay, buddy. This should be into my Palafin to KO. Yeah. Okay. And then, are you setting Tailwind, or are you just going for, like, Hydro Pump? Should be Hurricane, right? Yeah, Hurricane to break my multi-scale. If they confuse, I have my Lumberry. Perfect. Why did Dragonite's feet eat the berry? The world may never know. Alright, so what protects? Both? Both is a non-zero chance of happening. What's my play if they don't protect? Take out the Palafin? They should just protect, right? No? Neither protect? Alright, and that goes down to another E-Speed this next turn. I eat that for days. Thank you, Assault Vest. That was a crit. I'm gonna Volt Switch to break the... That's incorrect. I'm gonna Wild Charge. If I go down, I still have E-Speeds to KO the Pelipper. Yeah, cool. Opponent not playing around Fake Out there, like, single-handedly won us that game, I think. Really, really close match, all things considered. And, like, that's kind of the reason I didn't want to bring Pelipper, because our opponent had multiple water types on their team, whereas we had just Palafin, and I didn't want to give Bundle, like, extra boost on its Hydro Pumps, you know? That was a really fun match. So what did we learn today? I think I've been giving Dragonite too much grief. And I feel like it's time for me to finally say that. Dragonite was good today. You know, we never terrored it, but, like, just putting on a ton of pressure with E-Speed was enough. Like, and being able to Ice Spin our way terrain against the Trick Room team was enough. Like, it did everything it needed to, and I think the multi-scale set was really relevant. Being able to live the Iron Head into it, and then be able to get another Extreme Speed off the next turn was really impactful. That Excalibur continues to impress me every time I play it. It just does so much damage. This Dragon Fang set is really interesting as well. You're just able to do so much extra damage and pick up so many other KOs that you weren't normally able to do. Palafin is pretty great. Even if you don't need, like, the rain mode here next to Pelipper, being able to just, like, lead it, get a free swap into whatever you need, thanks to, like, Fake Out or Rage Powder, or just being able to pressure your opponent correctly, can lead to just, like, a really good board state for you later in the game. There was also the game where we brought it in the back, and we were able to, like, take a KO, swap it out, and then bring it in the late game and be able to have it be our end game. Iron Hands is what else is there to say about Iron Hands? There's a reason it's the second most played Pokemon in this format. It's good. It's really, really good. And Amoongus honestly, the Terra Steel Amoongus was really good in the game where we played against the Palafin Mirror. You know, had they not had, like, close combat there, like, Amoongus just kind of sits in front of them and does whatever we need. But we also got off, what, multiple spores in that game, so... You know, Amoongus was really impactful in the one or two games we brought it today. So, that is going to be it for me today, everyone. Like I said at the top of the show, if you're watching this the day it comes out or the weekend this comes out, I'm in Knoxville. Come see me in the convention center. Come hang out. And, you know, as always, like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next week. Have a good one. Peace.